It's wonderful to be here. It's, I always start with two different parts. The costume change for being in the field this morning. It's a really lovely to be invited, actually, and to have Callum invite me along here. And obviously, playing games really here over the years, but it's really lovely to be here and see Diamond Creek grow. I think certainly when I first started playing Diamond Creek, we were near the top division of the WFL and sort of down Division 3 and sort of acquired some players through Surrey Park back in the days where it was really tough for clubs to be sustainable. So it really is a tremendous credit to all those women and women who've been on the journey. I know how incredible hard work it is, but also how much fun it is to go on the journey when you are climbing up that mountain, and certainly Diamond Creek Footy Club has climbed up that mountain and been such great ambassadors for our sport. And particularly, I guess, from my end, from the work that I do at AFL Victoria with the under 18 girls, it's so wonderful to see a club like Diamond Creek with the values and the sustainability that it has to invest in young people. And the work that we've done to build, to be real leaders in this region around having age-appropriate footy for young women and girls across the northern suburbs of Melbourne is a true credit to yourselves. And you are such trailblazers and pioneers in this region. You know, when clubs who aren't too far away from you haven't really committed to young people as much as you guys have. And I just want to applaud Diamond Creek Footy Club for the work you've done in providing so many girls and women with the opportunity to play back. Give yourselves a round of applause. I'm really fortunate in my role. I mean, I used to be a school teacher in former life, and some people ask me, do I miss being a teacher? And I do. I miss the time that I had in the classroom with the kids, but certainly what I get to do now in the Under 18 Safe Program, in the Under 18 Youth Girls Academy that we've built, and I know there are a number of representatives that have come out of this club who've been involved with our academy. It's just wonderful to work with emerging adults and with young women and provide them with strong, positive female role models and strong, positive male role models that love and appreciate what they do as footballers. I think that's incredibly powerful that we do have really critical men in our lives that appreciate us so that we can stand on their shoulders and be a reflection of their commitment and investment in the game. It's wonderful to do that, to have the role and be involved with the growth of the game. It's wonderful that Diamond Creek have always made sure that there are club representatives, whether it's state trials or academy trials, and the club's always shone in that regard and really encourages their kids to be part of our programs. You know, there are some terrific kids, and I know that Nemo Connell this week was named as an emergency in the top 35 for the Big Metro team. Credit to the work that she's done in developing her footy. And she's such a coachable athlete, I'm probably going to embarrass her by speaking about her. But I'd like to do that because I guess, you know, we certainly have a belief in our high performance program that attitude reflects leadership. And if the sorts of leadership she's getting at this club are reflected through the way in which she carries herself and conducts herself, then you're doing some pretty good things here. Our program at AFL Victoria with the Youth Girls Academy, this year we added a mental health and wellbeing program to our program, because at the end of the day we just play football and it's not really that big a deal. And I know that, you know, I've been involved in the game for about 20 years now, and for someone that commit a lot of their life and a lot of their working hours to the game, to say that it's just a game and who really cares, it's just a sport, we don't really do the amazing catch ball well and kick it straight through 2 big sticks, but really, how does that impact our community more broadly and the whole planet, I guess. So I think for all the time and effort and energy we spend with people in this game and committing to this game, if we can actually use the game to facilitate and foster growth of our community and growth of our young people and growth of our capacity as, you know, I guess almost as a species, then we actually are doing some great things with the game, because yes, it is just a sport, it's not life or death. You know, what is life or death? That's people, relationships, connection, empathy, love. And I think our sport is really well positioned because it's so close. I always talk about it being a metaphor for life. You can be tall, short, and small, and large, slow. And there's a spot for you on the footy field that we can put you. And I think that's a wonderful metaphor for life. Everyone has strengths, everyone has weaknesses, and the most important thing is that we come together and we collaborate and we complement each other's strengths and weaknesses so we can all have a great result, hopefully on the scoreboard. And I think that's such a wonderful thing that football, that you know, AFL, Australian football can harness. So when you go through the season this year, you know, regardless of the scoreboard, because I will talk about this all the time with our state girls and our academy girls, it's been very precious focus. You know, have good processes in place that mean the scoreboard results both in life and on the field are taking care of themselves. but more importantly, I don't feel like a single person with the people that you carry yourself amongst. Whether you're in Benelli, you play with 17s, and you are helping out the under 15s, you know, what's your legacy? How are they going to be reflecting what you do? Have to think about that across the years. And just because you're in the under 12 team, it doesn't mean you can't get the under 18s or the senior players. I'm inspired every single day of my life by children, you know, young girls, young women in the game. I get out of bed every morning because they inspire me to work for them and work harder every day to provide them with more opportunities. Why? Because continually they display the courage that's required sometimes to get out there and male dominate the industry, male dominate the sport, do something that's never been done before. It takes a lot of courage. So every day I'm inspired by that. And I encourage you to seek inspiration and aspiration amongst the people that you're with. And you have a wonderful club with so many players. I think you actually have more players across the states. And in fact, I think more players in the whole country than any other club. So it's a credit to yourselves and utilise the time that you have together to really foster personal growth and development. Because that's where the true power of our game is, the way in which we can foster community, harmony, connection. Because that's the stuff that makes life worth living and makes life much easier to be amongst. So congratulations, wish you well for the season, not so much for the scoreboard, but more importantly, not for those reasons. But I wish you well across the season into the new process. I really hope that you have a wonderful season together, that you make positive and wonderful contributions, not only to the people that you play amongst, but the people that you play against, because they're in opposition, but not in the practice you craft. And I think our opposition is just as important as ourselves. So I do wish you well for the season. Have a wonderful season together. Make sure you invest in those young girls and keep making sure that when they play for you in the future, that a little bit of yourself is reflected in what they do and what they do next. Congratulations on a great year.